It's week 9 of the National Football League, and we've got the Seahawks, reigning league MVP. He's been sensational as he leads the league in touchdown passes. It's the Seahawks and the Rams, and it's coming right up on EA Sports.
The Santa Ana winds, so prevalent this time of year, they rolled through and they left us with bright, clear skies here in Los Angeles, California. Today, it's a week 9 matchup. We're all set to go as it'll be the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Los Angeles Rams. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Rams team as they interplay. They come in off a loss last time out, but they've been playing better than 500 ball the last couple months. 5 wins in their last 8 games. Meanwhile, for our visitor. So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. And trotting out there leading them is their 4th-year quarterback.
And I think if you ask most folks to give you their first half MVP, very likely they're going to say it's this man right here, the NFL's leader in touchdown passes. To this point in the season, still 2 months to go, but if he can keep going to the pace he's at, this is going to be a dangerous team come January, and he could very well walk away with the MVP.
Now the first carry for Bush, and he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, 2nd down. You talk about this Rams defense.
It's quite a unit, number 1 in the NFL against the pass.
And this is one of those something's got to give games. You've got the number 1 passing team in the NFL against the number 1 defense against the pass. A lot of times, the battle's in the trenches. We know that. We see it all the time. But this one, this game's going to be one on the outside.
Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's 3rd down.
And Cameron Hayward's ability to take on blocks, hold the point of attack, and get upfield serves him very, very well. What a nice play there.
Yeah, he can take on blocks because he's built like a block.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9. Jackson. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Throwing now, Jackson on 1st down. This is Reese on the ground. So the completion good for just 3. And it's 2nd down.
The Seahawks at 7-1 now on the year. And they coming on a pretty good roll here. Winners at 3 straight.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
On 2nd down, Jackson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metchie. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 26. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And Jackson throwing once more. Connects with Kittle underneath. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. On 1st and 10, it's Jackson. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play.
The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside.
Now Jackson on 2nd down. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on 3rd down.
On 3rd down, Jackson. And they're going to get him. They bring it down to sack back at the 16-yard line.
Quiddy Pay getting in there and burying him behind the line.
It's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you.
Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their 2nd drive.
Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of whatever power rankings you want to go by, they're at or near the top of the list in terms of best teams in the National Football League.
And for me and my little bit of rankings here, I've got them at the top. I know there's still 2 months to go, and we've seen teams get off to hot starts and then fade away due to injuries or the schedule or whatever. But unless there are a rash of injuries on this team, I'd be surprised if they aren't a first or a second seed come playoff time.
On second down, here's Jackson. Over the middle, complete. It's Reese. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 27 yards there, a first down. Jackson now. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get ahead of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Seahawk football here to start quarter number two, as they've got it 2nd and 7. To throw is Jackson. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to 3rd down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
Again, Jackson connects with Kittle underneath. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he's going to get this down inside the 5 before he's out of bounds. It's a big play there for Seattle. 43 yards after the big play. A chance to finish now on 1st and goal. Here's Jackson to throw. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Cameron Hayward able to record his 5th sack of the season. So they get pushed back to the 11. And here's 2nd and goal. Now Jackson going to shift him around. Here's Jackson looking to throw on 2nd down. Finding Johnson on the out route. That's complete. 5 yards that time on the completion. And now it's 3rd and goal.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred the defense.
No gain on the play that time. So a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a 4th and goal. Let's think here. You're still just in the 2nd quarter. You taking the 3 points?
I am taking the 3 points, and I'm just relying on my defense here. Show me I have a little confidence in them, and let the offense know, nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get 6 then. But for now,
Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in 1st place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number 1 goal? Make the playoffs. Number 2? Win your division. Number 3, and I think the biggest goal of all,
Try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way. Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Second down and 8. Now it's Jackson. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Jackson will throw again. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Rams will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. And, Charles, that's now 4 interceptions over his last 3 halves of football, because, remember, he threw 3 picks last week.
Starting to wonder if maybe defenses and those coordinators have identified something on tape with what he's doing, maybe a movement, maybe the way he's moving his shoulders. Who knows what it could be? He could have a few tells out there that they're keying in on and allowing defenses to get to the football a little bit faster.
And the Seahawks offense going to get one final possession in this first half. And leading 10-7, yeah, they may just want to get this to the locker room. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Bush. And all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. A great effort there as the first half is winding down. And the Seahawks would extend their lead here just before halftime. Boy, Charles, this offense is just so explosive. They lead the league in scoring, and another example of just how good they are right there on that play.
Yeah, we often overstate about how explosive teams are, but this team is truly a threat to score on every snap, especially on the first few plays of any series. And a big strike like that, that only adds to their reputation.
Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half. Jackson on first down. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. Following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Here's Jackson. Right side completes to Metchie. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. Now it's Jackson. Johnson's got it complete. And the Seahawks are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield.
Touchdown, Seahawks! A great play there. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a 3-score lead.
Now that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench because they accomplished exactly what they set out to do. Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves offensively, they helped their defense out as well.
Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. He's played well. Good first half. He's continued that here in the third quarter. But my question, when you're a head coach, what do you look at stat line-wise for your quarterback? Do you go right to turnovers?
You really do. As much as coaches don't want to talk about that, that's where it starts. When I played in college, our first rule for every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. And that's kind of how they judge you. Do you take care of the ball, not turn it over, keep it in the proper hands, and give your team a chance to win?
Well, that's what he's done here in this one so far.
Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's second down and 8.
Jackson from the shotgun.
There's a short one to the tight end, Johnson.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and that will bring up 3rd and 1. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
On 3rd and 1, Jackson, and they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. They'll try and throw for it with Jackson.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. First down on a pickup of 11. To throw again is Jackson. Connects with Kittle underneath. So the completion good for 7 there, and it'll be 2nd down. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now 2nd and 3. Jackson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That he's brought down, but he has it down to the 12 on a pickup of 12. 1st and 10.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Now Jackson on 1st down. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
Throwing is Jackson. Eluding the... Jackson hit, and he lost the football.
On one of the linebackers has got it.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Hey, we can push ball security all we want here, but how about that effort on defense?
Excellent job inside the red zone. Just took away at least 3 points by forcing that fumble.
L.A. readies for its next possession. And the fumble recovery was an important first step, but still a huge fourth quarter hole to dig out of. Down 3 scores. Ball now going back over to the Seattle Seahawks offense. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. Here's Jackson, flushed out right, and he just throws this one away.
Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise or throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
The offense on third down, they've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. This will be caught just inside the 10. And this will not be enough. On 3rd and 5, he only gets 3. This offense 2 for 2 converting on these thus far, so why not try again here on 4th down? They'll go for it. Jackson. Touchdown! A great effort there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Seahawks are about to make it 4 straight as they add to this 4th quarter advantage. He's got them out now to a 3-score lead here in the 4th quarter after that one, CD. And, well, he looked right off the line like he knew that that ball was coming his way, and he secured it for 6 points.
Yeah, and I think when you're leading by a healthy margin already, it actually loosens you up and allows you to take maybe a few more chances and definitely play with more confidence, because he's...
Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And it would seem as if their 3-game winning streak is about to go to 4, but still a little work to do as they start 1st and 10. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that will bring up 2nd down. From the gun, it's Jackson. He finds Kittle going across the field. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain there of 21 yards. Throwing on 1st down, it's Jackson. And this heads straight to the sideline. I don't think they're going to let him get away with that. Nope, they won't. Here comes the flag. We saw it too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
They lose the yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly 2nd and long. Now Jackson. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
This is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 14. A real letdown defensively. That was 3rd and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Oh, Jackson's going to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. Now, following the sack, they'll come up here on a 2nd down and 12. Jackson now. Flush to his right. And the catch made by Johnson. And he is going to lose yardage here. So the victory here for Seattle, and they've got to feel good about this performance. I think you'd agree, matched up against a top 5 defensive unit in the league, and they pretty much had their way.
Yeah, that was the interesting part about it, because normally when we see this defense play, they have their opportunities, and they make their plays, don't they? They knock them back on their heels. They take the ball away. They change field position. In this case, what you said is so apt. They had their way with them, took it to them, and knocked them back.
my check real quick.
What you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm rapping? I'm cutting my hood like they call me the blessing. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. At the way I get hectic, dumbing me slide up on you, no electric. Get hit on like it's Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text and listen. I don't know why they mentioning beef. I don't think no one better than me. You can say what you want, but my steppers don't speak. If I tell them to go, then they stepping on three like board a chain that's competitive. Me making rain in your hood like I weather the streets. If my label we good, I'ma get to the breach. You only as tough as your weapon could be. I done caught me a deal and I got off the block. To the hate and put that in the watch. Had the ice on my neck, cause I'll shorty on hot.
This is how we do it, boys. Let's get it again next week.